Visuals play a powerful role in conveying information, evoking emotion, or igniting actions or change. Understanding how they do that is what we call visual literacy, a cornerstone for 21st century college and career success. Just like we teach students the grammar, style, and syntax of written language, visual literacy teaches students the building blocks of visual design and the different ways of graphically presenting information. So whether it's an infographic or graphic novel, political cartoon or data visualization, a design prototype or animation, students learn to harness the power of visual language across media and subject areas. In Adobe's activities for the Pixar in a Box's lessons on visual language and film grammar, we empower students with our suite of creativity and communication tools to become storytellers themselves, to not just analyze, but to create captivating visual narratives. These lessons encourage students to do things like analyze the use of lines in movie stills,
and experiment with representing feelings and characters using single lines in a Creative Cloud Express post or Photoshop.
Consider how contrast can impact the tone and mood of an image, and practice the use of shading to direct the viewer's eye. Learn how different shot types can influence the viewer's sense of tone, character, and conflict, and apply that understanding to bring moments from their own narratives to life, and synthesize the principles of visual language, film grammar, character, and story structure to storyboard a full movie scene. Let's hear from educators who have used Adobe and Pixar in a Box to teach visual literacy in their classrooms.
Students really love to learn anything new and to be able to take whatever they're learning and apply it to what they're doing. So learning the tools of visual language, whether it's how shapes work or how colors work, or learning film grammar, understanding a wide shot and a long shot, and thinking about how it all comes together, it takes what they want to tell, the stories they want to tell, and it gives them tools to make it even stronger.
Activities involved in this included things like moving around, listening, seeing, speaking. And I think that's really important for the learner as a whole, the kinesthetic learning, because we do learn more with moving and movement.
They were able to come up with new stories really quick, really fast. And we did like a rapid story development. We touched on the character development process and a little bit of visual language because we needed their actual images to be a major part of the story that they were telling. And they were able to create storyboards with minimal amount of text.
In the Pixar activities on film grammar, one of the really cool ones I like is where students start to apply basic shot types they learn about. A lot of students maybe won't have thought about those types of questions before from that perspective of like, what's the camera doing and how can it help me tell a story? And thinking more broadly to other applications outside of storytelling and film, there's both that sense of like, what do I want my audience to get